Hey there, adventurers, and welcome back to another episode of the Awkward Dungeon Master. This week, I wanted to take a moment and show you guys my recording space, which also doubles as my DM station. So, first off, you can see behind me, I have all my drawers of miniatures. I had to upgrade to 4 shelves here just recently, but I have everything separated. My larges are in their own drawers, and if you come over here a little bit, we've got all of my smalls and mediums, and then this far side, just ignore the tower of to-go cases, has all of my set pieces. And then I also have a drawer for map pieces and extra DM screens and stuff like that. So those are those, but on top of that we have all these wonderful stacks of books and things that it turns into a hot mess. So from time to time, I do have to sit down and actually sort everything clean, like put it away, because stuff winds up just getting set here a lot of the time. I'll have miniatures that need repaired, like this one that my husband 3D printed. One of the maces actually broke in half, so I've got to glue him back together. But then, you know, I've got some invisible bookshelves up here, and then all of this lovely art. Someday, there's going to be a map right there of our underwater campaign, the entire world that we're playing in. I wanna do a video on making maps where you guys will get to see me make that one of these days. Who freaking knows? But then even higher, cause you know I'm short, if we go all the way up, these are all my extra large minis that don't fit in those drawers. So I've got shit everywhere. You don't even know. And I know I saw this just a second ago. This is the emblem for my very first campaign, the Party's group banner, because their name was Beaksbane, which, you know, they killed a bugbear. No, not a bugbear. They killed an owlbear on their first actual mission that was terrorizing a local main road, and they kept the skull. So anytime they would introduce themselves out places, they'd be like, "We are Beaksbane." So that was a thing. So that's my DM station stuff. We also have, you know, excess things that I sometimes need live down here under DM station. So extra dice. Joe's dice are typically down there all stacked up. And then I have extra books. My big note binder for running my games is down there, so that's fun. And then if we spin around to the business end of everything that's going on right now, the first thing you're going to see is my computer, because I am recording Audacity on my Yeti mic. So that's all my audio set up there with my laptop. It's usually just outside of the screen, so you can't see it. And then, of course, my microphone. And I'm going to be doing a video here soon on Goblin Dice Hoard acquisition. So I've got all these lovely dice set out. I do change the set every time I film. I don't know if anyone's picked up, but I sometimes do film multiple shots in one day. I just change my shirt. So hopefully no one can tell that I'm filming 3 to 5 videos sometimes in a week because I have some extra time. But typically when I'm filming, I also have some notes. So these are my notes for all the dice and who I got them from, so I can plug their respective social media platforms if you guys want to go get some for yourself. And then if we keep moving on along, please ignore the state of our living room. It's always a mess. It's a catch-all. So I have 2 lights for some lighting set up in here, because otherwise everything looks kind of washed out and sad. So those will get turned on whenever I'm ready to record. And then of course I have my tripod with my camera. Joe was nice enough to get me a camera that records continuously for Christmas this last year, so I don't have to edit 12-minute segments together anymore. So, it's my studio. Hopefully you guys enjoyed taking a quick look at that. Until next time, keep it rolling, adventurers.